Good morning. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to worship here at Braddock Street Church. My name is Kirk Knave. I'm one of the pastors here along with Reverend Annalise Stevens Jennings. And here at Braddock Street, we seek to be followers of Jesus who love God and worship, love others in small groups, and who serve the world in mission. If you have a particular prayer request this morning, you can write that on this blue card. The ushers will come through during the first hymn. They will collect those. Want everyone to know we will not be using those in worship today because of the cantata, but we will share them with our prayer team throughout the week. If you're new among us, we've got a green card in front of you in the pew rack for you to let us know a little bit about yourself so that we can contact you and get to know you a little bit better. But now I invite you to stand as you are able. Feel free to wave your palm branches as we sing together All Glory, Laud, and Honor, hymn number 280.
Thank you. The next day, the great crowd that had come to the festival heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So they took branches of palm trees and went to meet him, shouting, "Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel." Jesus found a young donkey and sat on it, as it was written, "Do not be afraid, daughter of Zion. Look, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt. Hosanna." This was John chapter 12, verses 12 to 15.
From Matthew chapter 11. But I tell you, on the day of judgment, it will be more tolerable for the land of Sodom than for you. At that time Jesus said, "I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent and have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father. And no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light."
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, who sent your only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sin, show me how I can honor you and bring glory to your name by walking in the way of Jesus. Give me grace and mercy as I try and fail, guidance when I'm not sure which way to go, and wisdom to trust you in all things. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. O Lamb of God, who takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Grant us peace.
Thank you.
We're now going to invite our ushers to come forward to collect this morning's offering, and we also want to remind you that next week we have an opportunity for Easter. There will be a separate special Easter offering, the proceeds of which will be split between three organizations that are close to Braddock Street's heart. One is the Child Safe Center, another is Family Promise Winchester, and the third is the Virginia Conference mission efforts in Haiti. And so we are excited to see what kind of wonderful ways we are able to support all three of these organizations in the name of the risen Christ. But for now, we invite our ushers to come forward.
From Mark 14. They went to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took with him Peter and James and John and began to be distressed and agitated. And he said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and keep awake." And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed that, if it were possible, the hour might pass from him. He said, "Abba, Father, for you all things are possible. Remove this cup from me. Yet not what I want, but what you want." He came and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter, "Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Keep awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. And again he went away and prayed, saying the same thing, same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough! The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand."
Thank you. As we come to the Lord's table today, it is important for us to remember that this table is a table of invitation for all. And as we begin today, we will take a moment of silent prayer and confession. Let us pray. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love towards us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen. Lift up your hearts and give thanks to God. God Almighty, in love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and death, your love remained steadfast. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, who humbled himself, taking the form of a servant, and became obedient unto death upon a cross. He took upon himself our sin and death, and offered himself a perfect sacrifice for the sin of the whole world.
And on the night he gave his life for us, our Lord took bread, gave thanks to you, God, and broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks to you, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. For this is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Pour out your Holy Spirit upon us gathered here in this room and upon these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, so that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes again and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in your holy church, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. Our Lord's table is now ready for you, and as Annalise said, all are welcome at Jesus Christ's table. We'll ask those that are going to assist us at this time to come forward. You will be served by a station in front of each of the seating areas, one to my far left, one here in front of the two center sections, and one to my right. If you're in one of the two center sections, please cross that center aisle and go to the far aisle on the left. It helps us keep from bumping into one another. If you need gluten-free elements, they're here next to the baptismal font at this small table. You're invited to come. Let us pray. Lord Christ, thank you for all that you have done for us, giving your life for us. Thank you seems so shallow. But let us rise from this sacred mystery, this sacrament, by which you have fed our souls to live as different people. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are able. Let us sing together our final hymn, number 286, O Sacred Head, Now Wounded. Thanks to all of our musicians who helped lead off Holy Week for us. Thanks to our youth who provided some special refreshments today, kicking off some things that will be continued. This week, many opportunities for worship. Thursday night, Holy Thursday, here, 7 p.m., we'll have our service with communion, remembering the Last Supper. Friday will be a community service at Grace Lutheran Church that we will participate in. Sunday morning, for those who have to be a part of a sunrise service, 6:30 a.m. is your chance at Mount Hebron Cemetery, again, a community-wide service, and then we'll have our normal schedule here for worship, celebrating the resurrection of our Lord. We hope that all of this music has made you appreciate all over again what God has already done for you in Jesus Christ. Live now, trusting in His love, with the blessing of God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.